New life in the UK, test chapter 3. Test 7. Along an illustrious history, early Britain. The Middle Ages, the Tudors and Stuarts, a global power, the 20th century, Britain since 1945. You have 45 minutes to answer 24 multiple choice life in the UK test questions. You need to answer at least 18 out of 24 questions correctly to pass. How old was Edward VI when he died? A. 15. B. 18. C. 35. D. 56. Correct answer, 15. Explanation. Henry VIII was succeeded by his son Edward VI, who was strongly Protestant. During his reign, the Book of Common Prayer was written to be used in the Church of England. A version of this book is still used in some churches today. Edward died at the age of 15 after ruling for just over 6 years, and his half-sister Mary became queen. Which of these is an accurate estimate of the number of casualties suffered by Britain in the First World War? A. 10 million. B. 2 million. C. 500,000. D. 8 million. Correct answer, 2 million. Explanation. Men from the West Indies, Africa, Australia, New Zealand and Canada also fought with the British. The Allies fought against the Central Powers, mainly Germany, the Austro-Hungarian Empire, the Ottoman Empire and later Bulgaria. Millions of people were killed or wounded, with more than 2 million British casualties. Which of these statements is correct? A. During the Industrial Revolution, canals were built to link the factories to cities and ports. B. During the Industrial Revolution, canals were built to link the mines in the mountains with factories in the cities. Correct answer. During the Industrial Revolution, canals were built to link the factories to cities and ports. Explanation. Better transport links were needed to transport raw materials and manufactured goods. Canals were built to link the factories to towns and cities and to the ports, particularly in the new industrial areas in the middle and north of England. Which of these statements is correct? A. Elizabeth I came to the throne when following a long reign. Her cousin Mary died. B. Elizabeth I came to the throne when, following a short reign, her half-sister Mary died. Correct answer. Elizabeth I came to the throne when, following a short reign, her half-sister Mary died. Explanation. Mary was a devout Catholic and persecuted Protestants. For this reason, she became known as Bloody Mary. Mary also died after a short reign, and the next monarch was her half-sister, Elizabeth, the daughter of Henry VIII and Anne Boleyn. Is the statement below true or false? The Reformation failed in Scotland and the country remained strongly Catholic. A. False. B. True. Correct answer, false. Explanation. Scotland had also been strongly influenced by Protestant ideas. In 1560, the predominantly Protestant Scottish Parliament abolished the authority of the Pope in Scotland and Roman Catholic religious services became illegal. Which country of the UK is not represented on the Union flag? A. England. B. Northern Ireland. C. Scotland. D. Wales. Correct answer, Wales. Explanation. The Union flag consists of three crosses. The cross of St. George, patron saint of England, is a red cross on a white ground. The cross of St. Andrew, patron saint of Scotland, is a diagonal white cross on a blue ground. The cross of St. Patrick, patron saint of Ireland, is a diagonal red cross on a white ground. What event in 1851 took place at the Crystal Palace in Hyde Park and showed goods and exhibits from Britain and across the world? A. The Great Show. B. The Great Event. C. The Great Exhibition. D. The Great Occasion. Correct answer. The Great Exhibition. Explanation. The UK also became a centre for financial services, including insurance and banking. In 1851, the Great Exhibition opened in Hyde Park in the Crystal Palace, a huge building made of iron and glass. Exhibits range from huge machines to handmade goods. Countries from all over the world showed their goods, but most of the objects were made in Britain. Which of these people was a great British playwright? A. Geoffrey Chaucer. B. Sir Francis Drake. C. William Caxton. D. William Shakespeare. Correct answer: William Shakespeare. Explanation: Shakespeare was born in Stratford-upon-Avon, England. He was a playwright and actor and wrote many poems and plays. His most famous plays include A Midsummer Night's Dream, Hamlet, Macbeth, and Romeo and Juliet. Is the statement below true or false? The 1950s were a time of serious unrest in Northern Ireland. A. False. B. True. Correct answer: false. Explanation: the 1970s were also a time of serious unrest in Northern Ireland. King Edward I of England annexed Wales to the Crown of England by which statute? A. The Statute of Carnarvon. B. The Statute of Carmarthen. C. The Statute of Gwynedd. D. The Statute of Rhuddlan. Correct answer: the Statute of Rhuddlan. Explanation: in 1284, King Edward I of England introduced the Statute of Rhuddlan, which annexed Wales to the Crown of England. Which of the following statements is not correct? A. D-Day was an Allied operation that attacked German forces in France by advancing through Spain. B. The attack on Normandy by Allied forces is often called D-Day. Correct answer: D-Day was an Allied operation that attacked German forces in France by advancing through Spain. Explanation: on the 6th of June 1944, Allied forces landed in Normandy. This event is often referred to as D-Day. Following victory on the beaches of Normandy, the Allied forces pressed on through France and eventually into Germany. The Allies comprehensively defeated Germany in May 1945. Is the statement below true or false? Norman French influenced the development of the English language as we know today. A. False. B. True. Correct answer: true. Explanation: the Middle Ages saw the development of a national culture and identity. After the Norman conquest, the king and his noblemen had spoken Norman French and the peasants had continued to speak Anglo-Saxon. Gradually, these two languages combined to become one English language. Where did the people of the Bronze Age bury their dead? A. Burial mounds. B. Earth barrows. C. Ground barrows. D. Ground houses. Correct answer: ground barrows. Explanation: around 4,000 years ago, people learned to make bronze. We call this period the Bronze Age. People lived in roundhouses and buried their dead in tombs called round barrows. Catherine Parr married Henry VIII late in his life. Who died first? A. He died first and she was a widow for the rest of her life. B. He died first and she went on to remarry. C. She died first and he never remarried. D. She died in childbirth and Henry remarried. Correct answer: he died first and she went on to remarry. Explanation: Catherine Parr. Catherine was a widow who married Henry late in his life. She survived him and married again but died soon after. Mary Stuart was forced to flee to England after being accused of murder. Who was she accused of murdering? A. Her brother. B. Her father. C. Her husband. D. Her sister. Correct answer: her husband. Explanation: when her husband was murdered, Mary was suspected of involvement and fled to England. Is the statement below true or false? Lands taken from Catholics in 17th century Ireland and given to Protestant settlers were known as plantations. A. False. B. True. Correct answer: true. Explanation: during the reigns of Elizabeth I and James I, many people in Ireland opposed rule by the Protestant government in England. There were a number of rebellions. The English government encouraged Scottish and English Protestants to settle in Ulster, the northern province of Ireland, taking over the land from Catholic landholders. These settlements were known as plantations. Charles I was unwilling to reach an agreement with Parliament. Following his defeat in the Civil War, what happened to him? A. He was excommunicated. B. He was executed. C. He was exiled. D. He was exonerated. Correct answer, he was executed. Explanation, the King's army was defeated at the battles of Marston Moor and Naseby. By 1646, it was clear that Parliament had won the war. Charles was held prisoner by the parliamentary army. He was still unwilling to reach any agreement with Parliament, and in 1649 he was executed. The last successful foreign invasion of England was by which of the following? A. The Normans led by William. B. The Romans led by Emperor Claudius. C. The Romans led by Julius Caesar. D. The Vikings. Correct answer, the Normans led by William. Explanation. The Norman conquest was the last successful foreign invasion of England and led to many changes in government and social structures in England. Norman French, the language of the new ruling class, influenced the development of the English language as we know it today. During the reign of Henry VIII, which country of the Union became formally united with England? A. Ireland. B. Northern Ireland. C. Scotland. D. Wales. Correct answer, Wales. Explanation. During the reign of Henry VIII, Wales became formally united with England by the Act for the Government of Wales. The Welsh sent representatives to the House of Commons and the Welsh legal system was reformed. An attempt by which group to put James II's son on the throne instead of George I was quickly defeated. A. English Puritans. B. French Huguenots. C. Irish Catholics. D. Scottish Jacobites. Correct answer, Scottish Jacobites. Explanation, when Queen Anne died in 1714, Parliament chose a German, George I, to be the next king, because he was Anne's nearest Protestant relative. An attempt by Scottish Jacobites to put James II's son on the throne instead was quickly defeated. Scotland changed in which two ways after the Battle of Culloden? A. Chieftains became landlords if they had the favour of the English king. B. Chieftains took control of the land away from the English king. C. Clansmen became tenants who had to pay for the land they used. D. The clans were entirely destroyed. Correct answer. Chieftains became landlords if they had the favour of the English king. Clansmen became tenants who had to pay for the land they used. Explanation. The clans lost a lot of their power and influence after Culloden. Chieftains became landlords if they had the favour of the English king. And clansmen became tenants who had to pay for the land they used. Sarkadeen Mohammed opened which establishment in George Street, London in 1810? A. Hindustan Coffee House. B. Mohammed Coffee House. C. Mohammed Shampoo Parlor. D. Pakistan Curry House. Correct answer, Hindustan Coffee House. Explanation, Muhammad was born in 1759 and grew up in the Bengal region of India. He served in the Bengal army and came to Britain in 1782. He then moved to Ireland and eloped with an Irish girl called Jane Daly in 1786, returning to England at the turn of the century. In 1810 he opened the Hindustan Coffee House in George Street, London. It was the first curry house to open in Britain. Which of these countries did not fight on the side of the Allied powers during the First World War? A. Bulgaria. B. Italy. C. Serbia. D. US. Correct answer, Bulgaria. Explanation. The Allies fought against the Central Powers, mainly Germany, the Austro-Hungarian Empire, the Ottoman Empire, and later Bulgaria. Who did William the Conqueror defeat at the Battle of Hastings in 1066? A. Boudicca. B. Kenneth MacAlpin. C. King C. Nutt. D. King Harold. Correct answer, King Harold. Explanation, in 1066. An invasion led by William, the Duke of Normandy, in what is now northern France, defeated Harold, the Saxon King of England, at the Battle of Hastings. Harold was killed in the battle. William became King of England and is known as William the Conqueror. Hope you like this video. Please feel free to write your suggestions in comment section for future videos. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching this video.